Lord. Mario Shote, Kelelia Shah, Mario Shote, Yasha, Kelelia Sotare, Kelemo Josho Sahasata, Mario Shikene, no, Setia Kalea, Eti Yoshote, Mario Kelelia, Se Morusha, Kelelia Samo, Yaya Sam. Oh God, we thank you this morning. Oh God, in the name of Jesus, Lord. Oh God, we give you glory, Father. Lord Jesus, we thank you, Jesus. You're good to us, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Oh, thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Oh, God, we're blood brought in the name of Jesus. Brought with the price, Lord Jesus. Thank you, God. Hallelujah, Lord. Oh, God, we praise you, Lord. Yes, Lord. Oh, God, this morning we praise you, Lord, for you are worthy to be praised, Lord. Oh, God, we thank you, Lord. Oh, God, you're God above every other God, Lord Jesus. Oh, God, if we had 10,000 tongues, we couldn't praise you enough, Lord Jesus. Oh, Lord, we thank you, Lord. Oh, God, we thank you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Oh, yes, Lord. Oh, God, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Oh, Jesus. Oh, God, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We woke up this morning. Thank you, Jesus. Our souls are saved, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. We are here and not the tail, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, for living water, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, for life. Oh, God, abundant life, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, we thank you for the fire this morning, Lord. Oh, God, we thank you, Lord Jesus. Oh, God, we praise you right now, Lord. In the name of Jesus, Lord. Oh, God, we worship you this morning. In the name of Jesus. We get blessed. Lord, thank you, Lord, Oh God, thank you that you are Jehovah Jireh, our provider, Lord Jesus. Oh, mighty God, Lord, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, Lord. In the name of Jesus, Lord. Glory to God, Lord. In the name of Jesus, Lord. Oh God, Yahshua. Oh Jesus, yes, Lord. Ezekiel Rosa, Oh yes, Lord, you are burden bearer. Oh yes, Lord, you are Prince of Peace. In the name of Jesus. Oh, is there anything too hard for God? Yes, Lord. We worship you, Lord Jesus. Yes, Lord. Oh God, hallelujah. Oh Lord, yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord, Lord Jesus. You're worthy, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Oh, God, we praise you, Lord. In the name of Jesus, Lord. Oh God, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Oh God, hallelujah. You've given us another day, Lord. Oh God, we praise your name, Lord Jesus. We worship you, Lord. Oh God, all your word is true, Lord Jesus. It's yea and amen, Lord Jesus. We thank you, Lord Jesus. Oh God, we thank you, Lord Jesus. Oh God, we know that you are God above every God, Lord Jesus. You're our King of kings and Lord of lords, Lord Jesus. Oh God, we thank you, Lord Jesus. Oh God, we thank you, Lord Jesus. Oh God, we give you glory this morning, Lord Jesus. Oh God, energize us, Lord Jesus. Oh God, give us supernatural divine energy, Lord Jesus. For we don't get tired, Lord Jesus. For your word said we won't faint, Lord Jesus. Oh God, we thank you, Lord. Thank you for your covenant, Lord Jesus. Oh God, we thank you, Lord. Hey, yes, Lord. Hey, yes, Lord. Oh God, we need you, Lord. Hey, yes, Lord. Hey, in the name of Jesus, Lord. Oh, bless your name, Father. Hey, yes, Lord Jesus. Oh God, we give you glory, Lord. Yes, Maria, Nana, yes, Sister, yeah. Oh God, we thank you, Lord Jesus. We give you praise, Lord Jesus. We're asking you bless the overseers of this house, Lord. Increase them, Lord Jesus, until there's an overflow, Lord. We don't take it lightly that they're opening the doors, Lord Jesus, where we can come in and pray to you, Lord. Oh God, we thank you for harvest time, intercessory prayer, college, Lord Jesus, for teaching us the things of God, Lord. Oh, bless it, Lord, until it overflow, Lord Jesus. Oh God, we thank you, Lord Jesus. Oh God, we thank you, Lord Jesus, for each and every student, Lord. First, second, third, and fourth year, Lord Jesus. Oh God, for the dean and the director, Lord Jesus. Lord, we thank you, Lord. Praise your name, Lord Jesus. Oh God, that is the college that will make a difference on the face of this earth, Lord. Yes, Lord. Oh God, that will bring prayer back to the nations, back to the home, Lord Jesus. God, yes, Lord Jesus, we don't take it lightly, oh, yes, Lord, oh, God, we thank you, Lord, that you chose us for such a time as this, Lord, hey, in the name of Jesus, oh, glory, Lord, everybody, your shoulder, hey, say, sing a little, super, oh God, that you are healer, Lord Jesus. Oh God, that you're always present, Lord Jesus. Oh God, we thank you, Lord Jesus, that you are the shepherd, the good shepherd, Lord. Over all the sheep, Lord. Jesus. God, oh God, you're more than enough. I said more than enough, Lord. Hey, get a little city. Oh God, we pray for the financial needs here today, Lord. Oh God, give them the mind of Christ, Lord Jesus. Oh God, let them know that we're not sufficient ourselves, but our sufficiency rests in you, Lord Jesus. Hey, you're breaking anointing this morning, Lord Jesus. Oh, yes, Lord. Hey, walking in your will, your way, no hesitancy. Oh, God, we bind everything here that's not of you, Lord Jesus. Every evil thought, Lord Jesus. Oh, God, every thought that's not of God, Lord. We command it to go in the name of Jesus. Every tired spirit, we command it to go in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, you have no place here, Satan. You have no place. Yes, Lord. Oh, this is a God time, a God season with God thoughts, Lord. Hey, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Oh, God, thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord Jesus. Mighty God, wonderful Savior, Prince of Peace, Lord. Bright morning star, lily of the valley, the I am that I am, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Oh, yes, Lord. Oh, God, we thank you, Lord. Hey, yes, Lord. Oh, many yaka la la sa ta mani no shote. Hey, can I sit in the sa? Hey, can I ask for the yasuta? Ah, yes, Lord, we ban the spirit of fear, Lord Jesus. Oh, God, we ban the spirit of fear, Lord Jesus. Hey, God, you're God all by yourself, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Oh, God, thank you, Lord. We thank you for breakthroughs, Lord Jesus. Breakthroughs, Lord Jesus. Oh God, Lord Jesus. Oh, divine health, Lord Jesus. Oh God, we praise you, Lord Jesus. Hey, yes, Lord. God. Yes, Lord. You said our bodies are the temple of the Holy Ghost. Oh, God, can these dry bones heal? Oh, God, yes, Lord. You said yes. In the name of Jesus. Oh, God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hey, yes, Lord. Even Lord, son of the Asapa. Oh, God, we are strong in you, Lord Jesus. We are one accord in unity with you, Lord Jesus. Oh, God, we thank you, Lord, for the sound mind, Lord Jesus. Oh, God, yes, for the sound mind, Lord Jesus. Oh, taste and see that. God, you said ask and we shall receive. Knock and the door shall be open, Lord Jesus. Oh God, thank you, Lord. I said this morning we're knocking, Lord. Yes, it is your shoulder, yes. Families back together, Lord Jesus. Under your threefold cord, Lord Jesus. Marriage is restored right now in the name of Jesus. Oh God, oh God, that prodigal son and daughter is returning home, Lord Jesus. Oh God, not only that where they live, but their church home, Lord Jesus. We're willing and ready to serve you, Lord Jesus. Ready to answer to the call, Lord Jesus. Oh God, thank you, Lord. Oh yes, Lord. Hey, yes, Lord Jesus. Jesus. We thank you for the call, Lord Jesus. We thank you for the mission, Lord Jesus. Not mission impossible, Lord Jesus. Oh God, but a mission is already approved by the Savior, by the Master. Hey, Jesus. Ah, yes, Lord. You said the steps of a good man is ordered by the Lord. He said that you're one of the most order our steps, oh God. Be in every decision, oh God. We thank you, Lord Jesus, for your wisdom, your knowledge, Lord Jesus. Hey, yes, Lord. Oh God, we thank you. A next level, Lord Jesus. A new level, Lord Jesus. Take us higher, Lord Jesus. To higher heights, Lord Jesus. Oh God, we thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank the Holy Spirit that you are here. We thank you, Lord Jesus. Oh, Holy Spirit, we thank you, Lord. We give you glory, Lord Jesus. As you cover this church and the churches, Lord Jesus. Oh, God, as you cover the pulpit in the blood of Jesus. As you cover Tulsa and the nation, Lord Jesus. We thank you for it, Lord Jesus. Oh, yes, put us under your wing. Oh, God, you said that he that dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty God. Hey, Jesus. Yes, Lord, that's where we abide, Lord Jesus. Under your wings, Father, we thank you, Lord. Stay there, Ekalosa, ha, Ekalia, Shote, Emanio, Shote, Ekalia, Sa, Emanio, Shote, Ekalia, Shote. God, oh God, let this be a year of prayer, Lord. Not just a day, Lord. I said a year of prayer, Lord Jesus. Hey, Jesus, oh God. Yes, Lord. Jesus, we thank you, Lord. Oh, yes, as we come boldly, Lord Jesus. Oh, God, let the boldness be nationwide. Oh, God, let the boldness be international wide. Coming to the throne room, Lord Jesus. Hey, God. Hey, God. Oh God, you said if we humble ourselves, you said if we turn from our wicked ways, Lord, you said
that you heal the land, Lord Jesus. Hey, we got to serve you, Lord Jesus. You are our answer, Lord. Hey, God, Lord, say the Lord's son. Oh, God, thank you, Jesus, for your enduring power, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, that we don't look to the left or to the right, Lord Jesus. Oh, God, that we keep our eyes on you, Father.
Oh, God, orande ari kere amare. Yete arosoto shere amakuete. Shurunda, shurundo, shurundo shete arote. Ole, amare shere arote shere amare kure doso kure yate shere arosoro kure yate. We just thank you, Lord. We just thank you from the bottom of our hearts. We give you all the praise and glory because you God all by yourself. We sing a new song for you, Lord. Yet on day, Kuno City of Mountain and Yamai. We sing a song of thanks. We sing a song of joy. We sing a song knowing that you and your will shall be done. It's your will shall be done upon this earth. So we walk in the faith knowing that it's your will that shall be done. We walk with the boldness knowing that it's your will that shall be done. We walk with the joy knowing that it's your will that shall be done. So we just thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord, and we know that it shall be done, not by power, but by your spirit, that spirit that exists within us, that spirit that raised Christ from the dead, that spirit that knows all the years and years that will come, that spirit, your spirit, Lord, we just thank you, Lord. We just thank you for your blood. We thank you for the blood of Jesus. Because out of the blood of Jesus is a reflection of your love, Lord. For you love us that you sent and gave your only begotten Son. For that ultimate sacrifice. For that ultimate sacrifice that we're able to come to you and call you Father God. That's relationship that no other has. We can call you Father God. So we thank you for that personal relationship where we can call you Father God. Holy Spirit, oh Jesus. Shero tu shere araki eri aroko. Ayo ka eri ano shere no dunda te eri ameku. Ayande, we stand boldly. Ayande, we walk this earth boldly. Ayite ano, knowing that you are with us, that no weapon formed against us shall prosper. Because with you be for us, who can be against us? So we stand boldly. So we bind it now in the name of Jesus. We bind it now in the name of Jesus. And we lose your love. Oh, Shedion, and we lose your spirit. Oh, Shedion, don't be any of my own day. Father God, as we walk this earth, we desire not things of this earth, but we desire your gifts of the Spirit, Father God. Give us a strong desire for your gift of hearing. Give us a strong desire for your gift of prophecy. Give us a strong desire for your gift of miracles. Give us a strong desire for your gift of gosh, Eddie, I want to get the gift of tongues. Put the head of my yellow and the gift of eternal tongues. That is the true blessing of you, Father, that we may bless others with healing. That is a true blessing coming through you, that we may bless others with miracles. That is a true blessing that we may have, that we may touch others and lift them up through prophecy. So we thank you, Lord, with our heart open, our heart desire, all your gifts of your spirit, Father God. Oh, city, amayete oroko. Hoy amero te quiete se arombo una vez. Oh, mayeri amayoto veri mambe. So we lay ourselves us prostrate to you, Father God. Oh, humble, humble, humble. We do not belong to ourselves. We belong to you. So whatever it is you would have us to do, just let us know, Lord. Guide us, Lord. Direct us, Lord. For we know you are our banner. Oh, siete amarondo tu eri alite. Na te lo tu te yaye yende ki epa huru rusa heri amaota. Pueya di quiero juta yeri amayeta. Sheri amatu eri amarondo tu yaye amaota. Help me to pray, Holy Spirit. Holy ayato kuwebu seheri. Mame lo luku. Ete amaki ete. Na geri ayite so kuwe amaku eri amondo. Pueya di quiere. Jesus, we shout out to you, Lord. We cry out to you, Lord. We cry out to you, Lord. Yeah.
So don't walk in any dismay. Don't walk in fear. Put your faith in me. Not in the government and not what's going on. Put your faith in me. And I will show you the things that you should do to honor me. I'm bringing this nation back to me. It's going to take a shake. But the shaking shall not shake you if you stay in my spirit. It's to shake the world. It's to shake those who don't know me. It's to shake those who do know me but don't trust in me to come to me. So don't get dismayed by the shaking. Just trust in me. And I will give you the peace. And you will see my glory. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Come on, let's receive that word. Hallelujah. Let's receive it with confidence. This is the confidence we have in him. Hallelujah. That whatever he's spoken, he will bring it to pass. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you for your word, Lord, your spoken word. Hallelujah. Sweeter than honey, the honey, come on. blessing in your word this morning, God.
Thank you, Lord.
Gloria, gloria, turning around some things in our lives. Some of you need to turn around.
Yes.
Jesus, diabetes is subject in the name of of Jesus. Heart condition, you're subject to the name of Jesus. All of a sickle cell, you're subject to the name of Jesus. High blood pressure, you're subject to the name of Jesus. Come on, children. We rejoice in the God our healer, who word of God. We rejoice.
of God, Jesus is Lord. Woo!
Move forward. no worries, no fret. We're moving forward. Hallelujah. Even with the spiritual gifts, we're moving forward. Truth. God's word is true. Hallelujah. You open doors that no man can close. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Thank you, God.
Thank you.
You're in our mental capacity. With his stripes, we're healed. Hallelujah! Thank you, Jesus.
How great is our God.
Sing with me. How great is our God. Oh, sing. How great.
How great is our God. Come on, this time sing from your belly. How great is our God.
Hallelujah.
Everywhere I go, I remember your goodness, Lord. Everything I face, I remember your goodness, Lord. I will not give up before the Lord Santa, as we remember how great you are. We will not throw in the towel. We'll think about how great you are. We will not give up. We'll meditate on how great you are. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Take the time to listen. Praise the Lord for this opportunity, and we will speak briefly into your hearts this morning. I know sometimes people don't want to talk about Satan and his demons, but we'll speak today for our knowledge, for our growth, so that we can be more effective as prayer warriors and intercessors.
Yes, yes.
And someone said, what's the difference? Well, prayer warrior prays a lot, and if you pray a lot, I'm sure there's times you intercede.
Yes.
So we use them interchangeably, but with the same meaning. And we pray, and I believe that you have determined I'm not just praying, but God is answering.
Yes. Yes.
Do I have a witness in the house?
Yes.
Amen. So on last month, we talked about Satan and some of the things that he do. And today we want to talk about the origin of demons. We're not on a witch hunt. We're not declaring everything around us. Somebody do something, start saying it's a demon. We're not caught up in that. Amen. This is simply for our growth and for exposure of what's in the kingdom of darkness. Amen.
Amen.
So we're not searching for demons. When somebody do something, we want to start casting out. But when we know their tactics and what they do, we can walk in wisdom. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So we spoke briefly on last month, the origin of Satan. He started out, God had made him beautifully, and he was a powerful angel. But the spirit of pride, spirit of witchcraft, all of that entered into Lucifer's heart, and into him, jealousy, and the things that I just named. Jealousy, divination, which is witchcraft, pride, all of those are strong men. And that's why the enemy tries to bring those into the body of Christ. They are strong men. But the Bible tells us what about strongholds of strong men? That our weapons are what? Not carnal, but mighty through God, and we what? Pull them down. So that means that sometimes those things may come to us, but we don't get into them.
That's right.
Amen. We pull them down by the power of God.
Yes.
Well, when Satan rose up and he used the five eyes, I will do this, I will do that. Everything that God had, he wanted. That shows jealousy. When he used I five times, that shows pride. And when he thought that I could turn this all around, everybody will worship me, he wanted to control the wills of the other angels, that's witchcraft, controlling. So God is not unfamiliar with those things. I don't know why we act afraid, because God knows where it started. But God was not having it. Amen?
Amen.
So Satan gets kicked out of heaven. Paraphrasing. And I like what Jesus said. I've been thinking about this all week. He said, I saw Satan fall like lightning.
Woo!
Woo! When I said that in my mind's eye, it's like everything he had was stripped.
Yes.
All those beautiful jewels and how God had made them, like the blink of your eye, it was over. Done deal. He was out. That's why when we look at him, we're going to say, that's him. Because he's stripped. Amen?
Yeah.
And he's stripped of his power if we take our authority. I like that.
Yes.
Glory to God. Amen. So like, I want to say, sometimes like any other thing, usually when people get disgruntled, usually, not all the time, with the leader, they get them a posse. Hey, I know I'm right. They get them a Osama bin Laden cell group. They get people who think just like they think. And they start talking and running their mouths and talking about this and look at that. And he didn't do this or she didn't they do that or say this. So they grab them a posse.
And in our day, that's kind of how you get a church split. That's how you get division, which is what Satan calls. Because when he fell, his posses came with it. About two-thirds of the angels fell with him, who got on his side, who agreed with him. Yeah, you ought to be the leader. You're beautiful. You ought to be in charge. They came into agreement. The Bible doesn't say that literally, but it's saying it. So they got together, and they all fell. So now today, we have Satan, and we have demons. And demons are those angels that gathered in Satan's posse. And that's basically how they originated. But let's look at John, St. John chapter 1 and verse 3. They were originally, let me say that correctly, created as angels.
St. John 1, mm-hmm. verse 3, mm-hmm. King James Version, all things were made by him, mm-hmm. and without him was not anything made that was made.
Okay, so when we look at him, that capital H-I-M, that can include God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. They were all made by him. But God made them to be angels. Come on. And anything that was made by him. So Satan himself, God made. That's why God is his boss. Y'all better wake up. Our Father is Satan's boss. Come on here. And he's put that same authority in his children. That's why we don't back up. Amen. That's not why we're not afraid to tell him we know where you came from and where you're going to end up. Come on. We are aggressive in the spirit realm. Thank you, Jesus. We use our authority in the spirit realm. Come on here. Because we're on the right side. Glory to God. Come on. So they were made by him, and he rules them, and he can control them. But guess what? He's doing that through us. Come on. Oh, wow. We're going to go through some things. Come on. Go with me to Colossians chapter 1 and verse 16. Colossians chapter 1 and verse 16. And if you got the heat on, I think we warmed up by now.
Colossians chapter 1 verse 16. For by him were all things created, that are in heaven,
right,
and that are in earth,
mm-hmm.
visible and invisible,
mm-hmm.
whether they be thrones or dominions or principalities or powers. All things were created by him and for him.
And for him. So when they decided they were not for him, they lost out. And when I say they, I'm talking about Satan and his demons. And they are forever lost. Come on. He's not omnipotent. He's not everywhere. We say he everywhere. Oh, I went to the store. The devil was there. Then I went to the laundromat. The devil was there. What are you doing following you? When you show up, he should leave. Oh, my son, look, here she come. Here he come. I'm out here. Come on. Oh, he's in my house. What are you doing up in there, up in there? When you walk in, the atmosphere change. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. So when they decided they're not for God, God is not for them. When they were originally made demons, they were like the other angels of God. They had the same attributes, the same position as the good angels. Because there are good angels. And those are angels that's for us. There's angels of war, and we need to learn how to dispatch them. With their flaming swords, ready to cut down and destroy. Come on, saints, those are good angels. Ministry angels who hearken at the voice of God. Then we ourselves have angels, not just one on one side and one on, we got slews of them. I know that's not a word. Lots of them. So why are we tossing and turning and losing our appetite because we're so grieved? You better wake up and realize whose army you in. Glory to God. We're in the army of the Lord of hosts. Thank you, God. Hey. And nothing is too difficult for him. Oh, thank you, God. Woo. If I had wings right now. Yay.
Hallelujah.
So when Satan rebelled against God, a portion of the angels participated in his rebellion.
Yes.
Help us, God. And God cast them out of heaven. Along with Satan, they were no longer spiritual beings. They became evil beings. They're evil. There's nothing good about Satan or his demons. No good thing dwells in them. Nothing. Come on. So let's go to Revelation chapter 12, verses 7 through 9. And Brother Travis, I just want you to know I haven't forgotten about you. Revelation 12, 7 through 9.
And there was a war in heaven.
Wait a minute. Hold up your Bible so they can know you're reading. Because people scared to say spiritual warfare.
That's right.
We're not in a war. I don't believe in spiritual warfare. War started in heaven. Hey! Exodus 12:3 says God is a God of war. Come on.
My God.
So read that part again, please.
It says, and there was a war in heaven.
Uh-huh.
Michael and his angels fought against the dragon.
Uh-huh. Satan. I'm sorry.
Okay. And the dragon fought and his angels.
Uh-huh. Spiritual warfare.
Yes.
Come on.
Yes, Lord.
They were warring. Trying to stop something. Good angels against bad angels. We already know who won. But keep reading, sister.
And prevailed not.
The bad angels.
Neither was their place found anymore in heaven.
You don't belong up in here. You better tell the devil that when he tried to show up at your house. You in the wrong place. Come on, keep reading. I'm getting carried away. Help me, Lord.
And the great dragon was cast out.
Out.
That old serpent,
uh-huh,
called the devil,
uh-huh,
and Satan,
uh-huh,
which deceived the whole world.
Uh-oh.
He was cast into the earth.
Ah.
And his angels were cast out with him.
Wow.
Yes.
Come on. Now, I'm going to point out several things. One is the different names of Satan we mentioned last month, and please forgive me, I did not make the copy. But he has to text me like every day. But anyway, his name, one of them is dragon. That's another word for Satan. That old serpent called the devil. There's two names right there. He's a deceiver. He deceived in who?
Satan.
The whole world, that TH means continuously. We're going to go into some serious intercessory prayer and we break down principalities and powers. But those are names of Satan. And notice where they landed. Read that last part. He was cast out.
He was cast out.
Uh-huh.
That old serpent called the devil and Satan, which deceived the whole world.
Okay, where did they land? Come on.
He was cast out into the earth.
Uh-huh.
And his angels were cast out
with him. So here he is today walking about, roaring like a lion, seeking what? Whom he may devour. So they landed on the earth. But that's okay, we got some fun. How many can say amen?
Amen.
Let's go and do a lot of scriptures to start out, and then we're just going to go in and just talk. 2 Peter 2:4. Now, let me say this. Being cast out and upon the earth, they are opposing God and his people. Yeah. While they are on the earth, look at me, saints, they are opposing God and God's people. I tell you, I knew this lesson was coming. Looked like I came under attack. I want to say like this little sister that didn't know any better. I don't know why the devil bother me. I don't bother him. I don't bother anybody. I don't talk about people. Oh, she got a list of good things she does. I said, sister, the fact that you accepted Christ as your Savior, you became a target for the enemy. But boy, I want to say, I don't know why he's bothering me. But he's in this earth to oppose God and God's people.
Yes.
You will face opposition.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Sorry to give you the bad news.
Oh, yes.
You already know.
Yes.
You will.
Yes.
But we're not alone. We have the power and the authority. Glory to God. Everything we need, we have been equipped.
Yes,
Lord. Thank you, God.
Thank you.
So although we may face some things, greater is God, the Father, God, the Son, God, the Holy Spirit on the inside of us than he that is where? In the world, on this earth. So we already win.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Okay, so let's go to our scripture.
2 and 4.
Uh-huh.
For if God spared not the angels that sinned, but cast them down to hell, and delivered them into chain of darkness, to be reserved unto judgment, and they spared not the old world, but served Noah, the 8th person, and a preacher of righteousness, bringing in the flood upon the world of the ungodly.
Okay. I'm going to be like my old school prayer teacher. She would say, I just want part A of the scripture. And part A stopped. I didn't tell you that. Where it says, and delivered them into chains of darkness to be reserved unto judgment. So some angels are chained up. They're chained until judgment. Come on. We need to realize we don't need to give the enemy that much power, that much room. And he certainly don't have any authority. Okay, Jude 6 will further confirm that some of the angels are chained. Jude 6.
And the angels were kept not their first estate.
Their first place.
But left their own habitation. He has reserved in everlasting chains under darkness unto judgment of the great day.
Okay, so how long are they chained? He have reserved an everlasting. How long is everlasting? Forever. Chained under darkness until the judgment of the great day. So we have confined demons and we have active demons. Needless to say, the leader of both groups is Satan. Satan has been called, or is called, the prince of devils. Go to Matthew 12:24. Who is called the prince of devils. Matthew 12:24.
But when the Pharisees heard it, they said, this fellow does not cast out devils, but by Beelzebub, the prince of the devils.
So they try to put that on Jesus. Jesus said, a house divine, it can't what?
Damn.
If I'm of Satan, why would I cast him out? Come on, man. Jesus said, you can, Satan can come, but he won't find nothing in me. That's what Jesus' testimony. Satan can show up, but we don't have nothing in common. He won't find any of his attributes in me, none of his traits. Nothing of the devil, said Jesus, is in Jesus when he was on the earth. You can't find no trace of him in me. Come on. Come on, can we let that be our testimony? You can't find it. I'm not into the group, anyway. So anyway, move right along. So he is called what? The prince of devils. He is prepared. Hell is prepared for the devil and his angels. And that will be their final destiny. Stay in the book of Matthew. And go to chapter 25 and verse 41.
Then shall he say unto them on the left hand, depart from me, ye cursed unto everlasting fire, prepared for the devil and his angels.
So that's confirming that hell is prepared for who? The devil and his angels. Yes. One more in Matthew, verse 8:29. We want to point that out, that Satan knows his final destination. His demons know their final destination. Matthew 8:29.
And behold, they cried out, saying,
are two men possessed by demons.
What have we to do with thee, Jesus?
They recognize Jesus. I said they recognize Jesus.
Yes, yes.
I said they recognize Jesus.
Yes.
They were possessed with devils, but they recognize Jesus.
Yes.
Come on.
Yes.
You ought to be recognized in the spirit realm. Come on here. Thank you, God. As soon as you go into prayer, you ought to be recognized in the spirit realm. Glory to God.
Yes, Lord.
Demons walk in this place, they better recognize.
Yes, Lord.
Young people say, you better recognize.
Better recognize.
Oh, I guess those are young people. Jesus, the Son of God. Come on.
Art thou come hither to torment us before the time?
Come on, what are they talking about? Before we have to go to hell forever? You here to torment us? Yes, I am. Here is your eviction notice. Out. Instantly. You don't have 38 days. Right. Come on.
Amen.
They understand that about you. Are you the in Jesus. Afraid the bills won't get paid. Come on here. Why are you being tormented? Afraid you won't come out. Come on. Why are you being tormented? That's not your destination. That's not your present. And it's certainly not your future. Come on. Take your authority. Look at your neighbor and say, take your authority. Ooh, how many love Jesus? Glory to God. So they already know where they're headed. And we just let them run in and wreak havoc. I hope not.
Thank you, Jesus.
Come on, they already know they're doomed. They're doomed. They fail. They won't succeed. They already know. Thank you, Lord. Okay, so throughout the Bible, demons are shown as active on earth. Let me remind you, in case you forgot, that Satan is not omnipresent. He's not everywhere. And he certainly should not be hanging out where you hang out. There's nothing in common. Come on. So saints better watch where they're hanging at. Sometimes we go in their territory. I'm just saying. Oh, my Father. I feel like Christianity has changed since I've been born. I was born again over, what, 40-something years ago?
Longer.
And it's like, things are different now. I'm almost feel like I'm backsliding. Help me, Jesus. Things have changed. I mean, what's the standard nowadays? Oh, I know, the Bible. Wait a minute, the Holy Bible. Amen. Now, even though Satan and his demons know that they are defeated, they still roam around. Come on. They constitute the power of the air. We're going to talk about that in Ephesians 2:2. The power of darkness, Colossians 1:13. And they are all under the control of Satan.
That's right.
Now, I'm going to go through these fast. But here are some of the attributes of demons. They are spirits. They can appear visibly. I'm not pushing this, but I've seen this commercial about Sleepy Hollow.
Oh, Lord.
And this actor, I say he take pleasure in that. One time I saw him, he's like, because I was doing something else and I looked up and he said that. He said, my name is Ichabod, which means what? The glory has departed. And then the other day he was calling his name, and you had to do things. They fixed up his eyes. He finds pleasure in that. He don't know. Then he's on the wrong, he's playing bad territory, or whoever put that together. But they can't appear visibly. They can speak. And guess what? Before I say this, I want you to turn to James 2:19, because they believe.
Uh-oh.
Yes. Demons believe.
Oh, yeah.
Do you believe?
James 2:19. Thou believest that there is one God.
Uh-huh.
Thou dost well.
Mm-hmm.
The devils also believe in trouble.
Come on. They believe. They know.
That's right.
They know God is real. They already know God will bring you out. But they don't be there. What you gonna do about it? Take them down. You got it, sister. You don't last up in here. They believe. And they tremble. They also exercise their wills. Their will. Like they told Jesus. Let's turn to that, because I don't want to say the wrong thing. Luke chapter 11 and verse 24. They exercise their wills.
Luke 11:24. When the unclean spirit is gone out of a man, he walketh through dry places, seeking rest, and finding none, he said, I will return unto my house.
He said, I will what?
Return unto my house, which I came out.
Come on.
Then goeth he and taketh him seven other spirits.
My.
More wicked than himself.
More wicked.
And they enter in and dwell there, and the last state of that man is worse than the first.
Come on. I will return. So they have a will. That's why we close every door. Come on, say, I close every door. Every opening in my body is closed to Satan and his demons. My body belongs to Christ. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. So they exercise their wills. They demonstrate intelligence. They have emotions. They have recognition. They have supernatural strength. They have supernatural presence. They are eternal. They have their own doctrine. Doctrines of devils. That's in the scripture. And of course we know they are evil. And I do have scripture reference for everything I just said. The names of demons. Demons are called evil spirits 6 times and unclean spirits 23 times in the New Testament. So sometimes we need to say, I come against every unclean spirit. In the name of Jesus. Every unclean spirit. Amen. Now, since Satan was up there with God, he learned some things from God. That God is organized. Hey. Woo! Everything about God is orchestrated. So when Satan got kicked out, he organized his little posse. So they are organized. And we're going to talk about Satan's organization in Colossians chapter 1 and verse 16. Satan is an imitator. We need to remember that. Not the originator. Come on.
All right. Colossians 1:16, for by him were all things created that are in heaven and that are in earth, visible and invisible, whether they are be thrones or dominions or principalities or powers, all things were created by him and for him.
Okay, talk about God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. Now, the scripture I really want us to focus on is Ephesians 6:12. Just we have read Colossians. But in Ephesians, it talks about what we wrestle not against.
Okay. Ephesians 6:12. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood.
Okay, stop. It's not against the person or the people. It's not them actually coming against you, the person or the people. Not flesh and blood. And that's where we get sometimes confused. That's why sometimes we want to take things, matters in our own hands. Even the court system tell you, don't into your own hands, take them to court. Amen. It's not against people. Sometimes people don't like you just because. They don't even have a cause. Sometimes people rise up against you just because. They don't even know why. But the person or the people is not our battle. I saw some people going forth on Facebook. One of them happened to be close to me. And I just put in there, please stop. You're not wrestling against flesh and blood. Recognize the power that be and call it done. They either wiped their page off or nobody responded. I didn't see anything else. Because it's not against each other. If the mother's board would stop fighting with the deacon board, and the deacon board with the sisterhood, and the leaders against the pastor, and we back and forth in the church. Come on, church, we got to wake up. We're not fighting against each other. Hallelujah. That shouldn't even be in our minds, because it's certainly not in our DNA. It'd be from God. God is not into that type of fighting at all. Am I right about it? And that's why so many things rise up in the church. We fight against each other. We're against each other. We talk about each other. We make fun of each other. We belittle each other. We find all kind of fault in each other. Come on, really? Come out of that. Come out of that.
Yes, yes.
Thank you, Jesus. If you want to fight, fight the good fight of faith. Hey, glory to God. Thank you, Lord. Praise the name of God. Because some of us, all of us are at different levels spiritually. We're growing and maturing. We come from different backgrounds. Glory to God. I grew up as an only child. Although I'm not. But when I went to college and had roommates, that was weird for me. What you doing in my room? Get up out of here, you know. I had to learn. I had to learn people, and I'm still learning. My roommates, my friends will tell you, they even had to show me how to do a pillow fight. Maybe I'll tell you. Come on. We're different. And we have to learn how to grow and work with each other. And the brother prayed it today in love. Glory to God. That's how they will know us, is by what? Our love. So we don't wrestle against flesh and blood, but against what?
Principalities.
Uh-huh. Keep going.
And rulers of darkness of this world against spiritual wickedness in high places.
Okay, so here's Satan's organization right here. Number one is principalities. Principalities are in the world, we know that. But their main territory is jurisdiction. Their main territory is government and nations. So when you think somebody's acting a fool because they don't know any better, you better recognize that 2 Timothy 2:1 that tells us to pray for those in authority. Let me tell you, that scripture doesn't say, okay now, when you come together, pray for those who are in authority. If I could shout,
woo, glory,
how forcibly, how fervently that scripture was written, you'll realize it's not a soft thing. Come on, intercessors. Principalities
Is that right? Come on here. There are principalities.
Yes.
And if they're not seeking God like they should and make that personal, not praying, I'm talking about presidents, leaders of nations, some of them don't even want God, first of all. They supposedly have godly counsel. That's been my prayer for years. If they don't have any of that, then why do you think we're coming up with the laws we have? They're on the territory of principalities. And we need to pray. I don't care who's your president. You better know who's your king. Glory to God. And this nation needs to turn back to God. Glory. Thank you, Lord. So principalities influence governments and nations. We should be praying for government and nations daily.
Yes.
Oh, God, help us. Thank you, Lord. Now, what's the next part of his organization?
Power.
And what else? They all did all those together.
Darkness of this world and against spiritual wickedness in high places.
Okay, so let's start with against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world. This is two categories of demons. One is work and the social, one political, then the other one, I'm sorry, social and political is one world, cultural systems is the next. And as we continue our study, we'll break down those two, because some things we have allowed to be a part of our lives as saints, we need to know where it originated from.
Yes.
That's what I mean. Things are different now. There were certain things saints didn't do. Now, some of it, I think, went overboard. That's just me. I didn't grow up in that. But you know, you can't do this, that. I'm not talking about you can and you cannot. But there are certain things that saints have allowed to be okay, even in our personal life, that we need to really pray and see, is it God approved? I kept wondering one day, why do people not pray? It's prayer time. But they'd rather talk. They'd rather do other things, and we're in the prayer service. Everybody don't want to hear from God. They don't. They don't want God to get into their business. He already know it, but we have closed some doors. Now, God, I'm keep this part of my life. Oh, help us today. People don't want to see God. People say they love God. They've been a part of the church, but you better not talk about fornication. I don't want to hear that. Let me move on. It's not just sexual sins. They don't want that. But we need to know, who are we listening to? My sheep, said Jesus, know my voice, and what else? The voice of a stranger, they will what? Not follow. Who's the stranger? He opposes God's will. We can pray and scream and shout and holler, but if we haven't given God everything, come on, saints. There are things God mentions that are not of him. And certain things we can't get in. Well, my pastor said, I just need to join the church roll. It's funny. But I'm thinking of people who believe that way. Well, I've been a part of the church since I was born. My mama brought me here after I was 6 weeks old.
know that's old school. New school, they don't wait that long. Some of these women know what I'm talking about. I've been here. I grew up in the church. That cannot save you. That didn't, the only role your name was written on was the church book, church records, until you get born again. Am I right? Come on. Somebody, yeah, I drink wine. If you want to talk to me about it, call me. For what? If God told you to drink it, help yourself, bro. But I'm not going over there. And I'm not going to argue with you or try to prove a point.
That's right.
I just know I don't want any unclean spirit to dwell in me. Now, I'm not talking about what he did is unclean. I'm talking about me. Work out your own. Come on, children of God. That takes me until Jesus comes to work out my own. If anybody have issues, I do. And God knows all about it, prayer warrior. I'm on the potter's wheel.
Yeah.
Come on. Have not arrived. Come on here. We better recognize there's powers and rulers of darkness in this world. And unfortunately, they don't have to go too far out in the world. They're doing some work up in the church. Y'all don't like me. Where's my security guard? Is he here? We'll call Pastor Al. Yeah, okay, I got to raise it. Woo! What else is in this organization? Spiritual wickedness in high places. High places were in the Old Testament where they worship. Uh-oh. This is how Satan works in the religious structure of the world. Organized groups vary in size. I kind of went somewhere with that, but it all come together, I pray. For example, who remembers Mary Magdalene in the scripture? She had seven demons cast out of her. Luke, turn to Luke 8:30. I'm going to be finished here real shortly because I want us to move on and do some praying. But let me hurry.
Luke 8:30. And Jesus asked him, saying, what is thy name?
He's talking to the demon.
And he said, Legion. Because many devils were entered into him.
Wow. Legions in the Roman army, which ruled at the time of Jesus, referred to about 6,100 foot soldiers, 726 horsemen. And where I was going with that, with spiritual wickedness in high places, is that they are divided and they come in sizes. Different sizes is what I meant. Some may have legions. Some may just have an open door and the enemy came right in and took a seat.
That's right.
Come on, saints. They vary in sizes. We're still talking about the organization of Satan. So we have different ones and sizes. 300, you go over there and take control. 6,000, you go in there and take control. How many know if somebody got that many demons? You better have the power of Jesus. But Jesus said, how many are you? You think Jesus didn't know already? He knew what he was dealing with. Hello, Christians. Know who you're dealing with.
Yes, yes.
Know your authority. Trust God to make right decisions. Because you might into somebody else's will. Come on, are you ready to deal with that? We certainly don't want to deal with anything negative in the church. I don't know where I'm going here, but I'm going to go. Because when that church makes us mad, we go to the next one. I know I'm right. Whoever needed that, take it. If you don't, use it for counseling. His forces are united. In that same scripture we just read, legions of demons, they were united in that person. They had a purpose. They had possessed that man, and they were going to take him out. Mary Magdalene, who has seven demons. Look, when they possess a person, they're not getting in there to fight against each other. Wake up, church. They have decided we're going to possess this person and we're staying here forever.
That's right.
Until they kick us out. They're united. Come on, church. What should we be? Oh, how sweet.
Yes.
Oh, how pleasant it is.
Yes.
When brethren dwell together, what? In unity.
Yes. Yes.
It brings a special anointing.
Jesus. Where are our standards? They're in the Word of God. His Word will stand and last forever. I want you to read this one, 1 Kings 22. That demons can change their function. They can change their function. 1 Kings chapter 22. 21 through 23.
And there came forth a spirit.
Uh-huh.
And stood before the Lord.
Uh-oh.
And said, I will persuade him.
Who was he talking to?
Jesus.
Oh, my soul. Bold. Let me stop right there. Look at me, saints. We're going to go through things.
Yes.
And Jesus is our King.
Yes.
And this demon going to talk to our Lord.
Yes.
And tell him what he's going to do.
Yes.
And you're going to sit there and suffer?
No.
You're going to sit there and try to figure out how to work it out?
No.
When we serve the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, come on.
Yes.
Come on out of there. That's not where you belong. Come on. So he said what? Restart him again, please.
And there came forth the spirit.
Uh-huh.
And stood before the Lord.
Uh-huh.
And said, I will persuade him.
Mm-hmm. Keep going.
And the Lord said unto him, wherewith?
Mm-hmm. How will you?
And he said, I will go forth.
Mama.
And I will be a lying spirit.
Mm-hmm.
In the mouth of all his prophets.
All of them.
And he said, thou shalt persuade him and prevail also. Go forth and do so.
Uh-huh. Who's the boss, really?
Yeah.
Who's the boss?
Yeah.
Who's the man?
Yeah.
Hey! He told, okay, you're going to go forth. You will do it. And what happened? 23.
Now therefore, behold, the Lord has put a lying spirit in the mouth of all these thy prophets.
Mm.
And the Lord has spoken evil concerning thee.
My. Listen, he decided, I'm going to bring a lying spirit, which is a strong man.
Yes.
Sometimes people lie.
Yes.
Saints, I know y'all don't. I told a few, God forgive me. I'll be transparent. But there's a difference between telling a lie and being under a lying spirit. A lying spirit is a stronghold.
Yes.
It's a strong man. Come on. A person under a lying spirit, every time they open their mouth,
yeah,
it's like they can't help themselves. They have to add a little exaggeration to it to make it look real good. People like that, and some of them will declare, I've seen with my own eyes, that they are prophetess. Yet every time they speak, they tell lies. Under a lying spirit. And I want to encourage us as parents and those who are grandparents, please correct our children while they're young.
Yes, yes.
Come on, fight it in the spirit realm.
Yeah.
Because children will lie. They're being influenced. And now we see adults that lie and prophesy. They're so deep. And every time they're talking, I'm not going to be that spirit. I'm going to go judge Judy on you. If it don't make sense, it's a lie.
Yeah.
Come on, saints. Don't let stuff linger. Well, I'll just ask God to forgive me when I get home. Well, you gonna make it home? You don't want that spirit. I see it. I see it. God help us. Be honest with God. Lord, I didn't mean that when I said it. Please forgive me. It was a lie. Be real honest. He looking right through you. You can't cover up with Jesus. And people who are praying and seeking the Lord, they see you. People who gossip normally, that's why you don't want to get in gossip. Normally, what follows gossip are the manifestation of gospel. Gossip is a lying spirit. That's the manifestation of a lying spirit is gossip. I don't care where it comes from. People can be on your job. And I hear the Lord saying, don't open your mouth for my protection. Because when they leave my classroom, they go on over to Miss McGillicuddy. I just made up that name. Well, I was talking to Miss Moore, we were saying, now you see. Do you understand? Some organization. Oh, let me quit. So demons can change their function. Notice this demon had a will. I will persuade him. Come on, saints. There are new levels for us. And the way we get there is not to take no demonic nothing. Some of the stuff we might think is cute, you better know where it's coming from. Because when we start talking about those, how to break down some more things, you're going to be surprised where they linger. Oh, Lord, help us. Okay, I'm almost finished. Where are they, what are evil or unclean spirits? Hear this. What's evil or an unclean spirit? Immoral acts. There are certain things that people do because they're single. And I want to encourage you not to do that. That's an immoral act. Some people teach. They say, well, the Bible didn't say anything about it. Is the kids in here? Everybody wrong?
Yes, I
have kids. Okay. The Bible didn't say anything about that, but it's opening up yourself to evil spirits. Unclean thoughts. Wash my mind of unclean. It doesn't have to be sexual. It could be an unclean thought about somebody in the church. I don't want to walk in here with those thoughts. Get out. Leave. And what if it's true? Pray. And don't share it with everybody else. And their sister-in-law. Because now you are the unclean spirit. Oppression is an evil and unclean spirit. Depression. Come on, saints. Depression will come. It comes under the strong man of heaviness. One of the manifestations of heaviness is depression. It'll knock at your door. But you're not going to sit down and drink coffee with me. You're not allowed. It comes. Women, it comes. Right, my sisters?
Yes.
We're not getting ready to watch TV together. I'm not getting in the bed, put the covers over my head. As soon as you recognize it. Because it can be subtle. Like, oh, that's you. Now, see ya. It'll come. Let circumstances arise. Can I speak to my single sisters? Let circumstances arise and you by yourself. It'll come. But you're not staying. Because I'm not living under circumstances. I had wings. I'm not bound by conditions. Come on here.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Yes.
You unclean spirit, get out of here.
Yeah.
And if you recognize this depression, go ahead and hit the spirit of heaviness. See, Jesus said, you can't get the good until you take the strong man.
That's right.
Depression may be the strong man. I'm sorry. Depression may be the manifestation, but heaviness is the strong man. Take him down. So you spirit of heaviness, out! Now don't go to Bobby Blue Bland and think he gonna build you up. Put you on some praise and worship. Satan has strategies, and his goal is to afflict the mind and the soul. Can I get just two more strong men? One is the spirit of infirmity. That's an unclean spirit. Sickness and disease can't dwell in our bodies. And then seducing spirits are unclean and evil spirits. That means they afflict your mind, your soul, your spirit man. They try to influence you to believe false doctrines. They'll seduce people into false teachings and false Christ. Come on. Somebody mentioned Jim Jones the other day. I always mention him. He started out, I think, okay. But did he tell the people one day we're going to Africa and drink some Kool-Aid, it's going to be full of arsenic? How many would have followed him? But he started out with false teaching. We started out right. Some of the healings, I think, were authentic. Then they started paying people to get out the wheelchair, to put on this cast. So some doctors had to be in and put people in the cast. And all of a sudden, they take it off and throw it. Who's hearing from God? Then he's what? He got their principality demon. He began to govern the people and tell them, this nation is no good. Principality demon is the strongest. That's why we got stuff going on in our White House. And then he tell the people, let's go to Africa, where there's peace and love. Seducing spirit. How many know it's praying time? Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you,
Lord. See, the Holy Spirit's already here, so we're covered. Nobody's gonna go with the wrong thoughts, wrong feelings, wrong teaching. Because the word of God has been released. Hallelujah. I love Jesus.
Yes.
Come on, every time you hear teachings about the demonic, just go ahead and love on the Holy Spirit, because he's the truth. Holy Spirit, come on, love him. You're welcome in this place. Holy Spirit, you're welcome in our hearts and our minds and our bodies. We give everything to you. Every part of our lives, have your way. Have your way. Have your way. Have your way, Holy Spirit. How many have and want the testimony that Jesus said? Jesus said, I only do, hey, what he tells me to do. I only say what he tells me to say. Come on, yield yourself to the Holy Spirit. I only do what you tell me. I only say what you tell me. I want to flow over. Fill me up, tell the Holy Spirit, till I overflow. Holy Spirit, we thank you.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. That's why we have to pray in the Spirit. Amen. We have to pray in our heavenly language. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. She said it out of the other people in the world, actually. So who do you think he's trying to come for? That's why we pray in our prayer language. You don't know a word we're saying. You don't understand it. Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Glory to the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Still want to come for a little time? Hallelujah. Glory to God. How many say I have a clean spirit? Because the Holy
they thought they were going to defeat it, do away with it. And we all know it's not the best plan in the world, but it's a decent plan.
Yes.
But the plan, Trump Care, was a terrible, terrible plan. It was only going to benefit the wealthy, the insurance companies, and do a lot of damage to the rest of us. So the Holy Spirit came down on Washington, D.C., on Capitol Hill.
Yes.
It rained at some of those Republicans. And their reasoning was their conscience wouldn't allow them to vote yes on that act. But it was the Holy Spirit that wouldn't allow them to vote yes. You know, so we just don't need the Holy Spirit to rain down on D.C. We need the Holy Spirit to rain down all over the world.
Yes.
And this is what this praise and worship song is about. Amen?
Amen.
Glory, glory. Holy Spirit, rain down. Rain down. O Comforter and Friend, how we need your touch again. Holy Spirit, rain down, rain down. Let your power forth, let your voice be heard. Come and change our hearts as we stand on your word. Holy Spirit, rain down. Holy Spirit, rain down. Rain down, O Comforter and Friend, how we need your touch again. Holy Spirit, rain down, rain down. your power forth, let your voice be heard. Come and change our hearts as we stand on your word. Holy Spirit, rain down. Glory, glory.
Thank you, Lord.
No eyes has seen, no ear has heard, no mind can know what God has in store. Open up heaven, open it wide, over your church and over our lives. Holy Spirit, rain down, rain down. Ooh, Comforter and Friend, how we need your touch again. Holy Spirit, rain down, rain down. Let your power forth, let your voice be heard. Come and change our hearts as we stand on your word. Holy Spirit, rain down. Glory, hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
I'm glad I went to the journey to always invite the Holy Spirit, especially when we have exposed the demonic. Amen. We always want the Holy Spirit to be the last thing that resonates in our heart. Am I right about it? Amen. Well, we have completed our fourth Saturday watch for March. The next one will be April 22nd. Asking that you come out from 8 until noon. Also, would like to invite you on April 14th. We will be here in the sanctuary, and the third year students will get their preach on teaching the last seven words of Jesus. And then Saturday we'll have a brunch and a speaker and some singers and praise dancers. I think even our children are involved. They're going to sing and make us happy and give God the glory.
Yeah.
So I ask that you come out and support us as well. And let's just dismiss. Father, today we thank you and praise you. We give you glory and honor. We give you the praise. We thank you for what our ears have heard and what our hearts have felt. We thank you for the precious Holy Spirit who's in control as we give him control now.
Yes.
May the Lord bless you and keep you and cause his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord bless your children and your children's children and everything you put your hands to do that's according to his will. May he bless it. May you be blessed going in and coming out. We bind every plot, every trick, every scheme of the enemy.
Yes.
We silence.
Yes.
Every demonic force in the name of Jesus. And we release the truth, the Holy Spirit, who is the truth, be released in our lives and in our hearts and those we're praying for and everyone that's connected to us. Holy Spirit, be released. We thank you now in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
My pastor and first lady could not make it this morning, but they want us to know that they love us and they're praying with us.